Do you know what the world needs more of? Lists. And not just any lists, but ones geared specifically toward comedy. And if, say, one were to make, I don't know, a definitive best comedic TV actors of the 21st century list, there is one person whom I believe totally and completely deserves to be on that list and at a higher position rather than a lower one. Now, I understand how in more recent years, this person has ruffled a few feathers with some of their comments on certain topics, but know that that is not the focus of this video. What I did want to focus on instead, as you can already tell from the title, is essentially giving Raven Symoné her flowers. And when I talk of flowers, I'm referring not just to her being an actress, but her as an overall performer. Too often we talk of giving flowers to people as being a too late kind of thing, and we wish that we would have done it sooner. And so because I have the ability to do so now, I wanted to go ahead and change that narrative and instead give flowers to someone that has made a huge impact on a lot of people, dare I say, generations, me especially. So this particular video is dedicated completely to Raven and her amazing comedic abilities. Now, for this video, I could take it back to the Cosby days or even when Raven was hanging with Mr. Cooper. But I instead wanted to focus on the show that really catapulted her career and the one that I think best shows off her honed comedic talent, That's So Raven. That's So Raven is a show that first premiered in 2003, but initially went into production at the end of 2001, making Raven not even 16 years old at the time of the show's inception. And I just wanted to call attention to that little fact for you all to keep in mind that for a majority of the show's reign, Raven was still just a teenager when she was doing all of this. But anyways, getting back to the show at hand, it follows the life of Raven Baxter, a teenage girl with two always down to ride best friends, an annoying, scheming little brother, and two loving and competent but still very goofy parents.
You have been acting up in class again. Victor, talk to your son.
Corey.
Angry voice.
Corey.
As she tries to navigate life, school, and oh yeah, her supernatural psychic abilities that she doesn't want for anyone outside of those people that I just referred to know about. Now, though she can see into the future, and one could think life would be a breeze, it's really not that easy. It's the fact that she can see impending situations that leads to the most trouble for Raven, because even if she can't control her powers, there's still hope that she can control the outcome. From the show's inception, that hasn't really changed. However, Raven herself wasn't always attached as the lead. While the show was still in development, Raven had initially auditioned for the role of Chelsea, and the lead character's name wasn't even Raven. It was Dawn.
What kind of name is Dawn? I'm from the projects in Detroit, and I ain't never met a sister named Dawn.
But as a true testament to Raven the performer, she was so good that the producers wanted her for the lead. And not only that, but they were willing to name the lead character, and by extension the show, after Raven herself. And this proved to be a really smart investment as the show itself went on to break records and create many firsts for the Disney Channel. Now, before we get into the how exactly is Raven a comedic legend, as if we didn't already know this, we of course first have to look at the what, which is comedy itself. Comedy, in essence, rests on tragedy. It's about unwanted situations arising that then result in some kind of suffering, sometimes to be fixed in the end. Comedy is very ironic in that way, in that the more desperate, unpredictable, wild, and or entangled a situation is,
an entanglement,
the more funnier that the situation has the potential to be.
Parkour, parkour!
Yes.
And that's pretty much the premise that this show was built off of. A young teenage girl who doesn't know how to yet control or really understand her supernatural powers, which then winds her in some wacky situations. This was the playground that the creators of the show gave to a vet like Raven to get as extreme and as loose as she did. And that really kind of brings me to my first point, physical comedy. Physical comedy is a great way of showing just how committed someone is to the storytelling art of comedy. And if there's one thing Raven herself was all about, it was the physical comedy. When watching the show, it becomes pretty apparent that Raven is someone who is very steadfast and sincere when it comes to the storytelling art of comedic acting and getting a laugh, even if it did mean putting her body on the line. Now, physical or slapstick comedy is one of the more older forms of humor. Before there was technical audio and televised programming, there was physical comedy. With body language being our inherent form of communication and expression, there's no wonder as to why something as simple as physical comedy resonates with so many in the way that it can and often does. With physical comedy, you don't need a high IQ or the ability to understand a verbal language or really anything outside of the person themselves, because it's all about using the body to sell the joke. Though this may be the case, it doesn't negate the required level of fearlessness and or skill or dexterity that when properly cultivated gives you someone like Raven. And please understand that when I talk about her physical comedy, I'm not just referring to her stunts, but also her overall animatedness, over exaggeration, or how she would allow for her body or body parts to move or be utilized in certain situations and spaces that even if it was something small, it still made that big of an impact.
Sorry, stomach.
I mean, honestly, go back and watch any scene and really pay attention to how Raven uses her entire body to aid in successfully conveying a story rife with genuine emotion. Looking at some quick examples from this particular scene from the episode Ye Olde Dating Game.
Hello? Hi, Gabriel. You want to go to the dance with me?
What? You're going with Ben?
But I kind of heard that you were going with Rachel.
It ain't true, huh?
Look, Gabriel, it's really sweet of you to ask me to the dance, but I'd love to go!
Whether it's the initial shock in her body to a rigid and upright position after getting a surprise call from her crush, to her body immediately melting into manic but still childlike and innocent contortions as she tries to hold in her excitement, to the use of a hand to silence any objections, to then physically grasping and trying to get a hold of the situation, only to then succumb to the temptation. You'll notice just how important Raven's body usage is and how if she had just tried to be funny simply with the words on the page, how much more of a boring scene that and all of the others would have been. And that really is what physical comedy is all about, giving life to different levels of action to allow for the telling of the story to really come alive. Another way in which Raven's physically comedic and just overall comedic abilities are adequately shown is through the many different characters that Raven became over the course of the show.
I'm going to be a master of disguise. I'm going to be a master of disguise. I'm going to be a master.
Raven is just so talented at all the characters she does.
Part of the show is she just creates all these amazing characters.
I guess you can call her the girl Eddie Murphy because she's, you know, different characters.
I have an idea. Maybe I should dress up like a janitor and follow her.
No, wait, I did that last week.
I know. I'll be the lunch lady. Okay, I'm gonna need an apron, I'm gonna need a hairnet. Ooh, a mustache.
Ray, why don't you just ask Chelsea what's going on?
Just ask her? It's like you don't know me at all.
I feel like if there's anything that this show is best known for, it would be Raven's many disguises. Whether it's the different costumes, mannerisms, accents, and everything else in between, Raven's ability to really commit and pretty much lose herself within these different roles allowed for the characters themselves to really come alive, cementing them in not just our minds, but also in our hearts.
We are two foxy mamas you just don't want to mess with. Get in, get in.
As much as we loved Raven Baxter, we also loved Liz Anya.
It's showtime!
And
Mr. Plutter, sir!
And her mother.
I'm Tanya Baxter, Raven's mother.
Her country cousins, Sunshine.
The Ballad of the Salad.
And the security guard.
We've got her.
Bill Bob.
Bob.
Yeah, Coach, and I'm Bill Bob.
Grover T. Windpipe. And of course, Boys in Motion.
Motion! Knick-knack, patty-whack.
I could keep going on, but you get the point. These different dynamic and one-time off characters meant as much to the show as the main cast did. They were that influential. Every week, if you knew to expect at least one thing from this show, it was that there was going to be some kind of new and crazy situation for Raven to wreak havoc in that would allow for her to become something else. And that is the real testament to Raven's abilities, not just as an actor or comedic actor, but as a performer. And it was often those crazy situations that led to the creation of some kind of disguise, even if it was a simple trash can, that would then lead to the most entertainment, not just humor. But focusing back in on humor and the physicality of it, another great comedic ability of Raven are her facial expressions. Now, I know that facial expressions could technically fall under the physical comedy body language umbrella, but honestly, I feel like Raven's facial expressions should be heralded all on their own. Now, the face is so important when it comes to communication, as you can already figure. Even down to the smallest of details, a person's face can provide us with so much context within any given situation, way more than words can, since it's more natural, making it harder to consciously control. The face says it all. Someone could say something or be doing something that's supposed to be funny, but if the face, one of the final pieces to the puzzle, doesn't add to or at the very least match the emotion or situation, then everything else is kind of done in vain. I mean, look at someone like Lucille Ball, who, for all intents and purposes, served as a definite inspiration for Raven and her character. Yeah, the situations, dialogue, and slapstick were all funny, but it was that vast catalog of facial expressions that Lucy had access to that would humanize her, in turn making the scenes that much better, thus pulling us in, making us love her even more.
Fips are a great big bunch of gyps!
It was that same vast catalog that Raven would find herself checking out, studying, and applying just a few decades later.
Can I borrow it?
It could be a lift of the eyebrow, a contortion of her lips, or the squinting of her eyes that would just so easily convey whatever emotion or thought that she had flawlessly and often hysterically each and every time. And this then brings me to my final point, timing. You could be someone that writes the best jokes, performs them with all of the commitment, body language, and facial expressions that you can muster. But if you don't understand timing, then honestly, I don't really know what to tell you. I mean, yeah, it can be taught, but to a certain degree, because truth be told, it is something that comes from within. It's rhythm.
Well, William, I don't really think they'd be that cheesy if someone had some rhythm.
Everything could be set up perfectly, but if you come in too early or too late, therefore messing up the entire flow, the joke that everyone works so hard to build up then becomes null and void.
Funkification to the highest level, get it?
It's all about being in tune with the musicality of life and language and knowing when to fall in line with it and at times comply with it, or at other times, subvert it. It's not about finding the perfect formula per se, but instead the perfect moment. And the best comedians are the ones that keep themselves and their minds open for that very real possibility. And Raven is no exception. I mean, just take a look at these quick examples. In this particular scene, Raven tells Devon that it's okay for him to give away her ticket to a convention that she didn't want to go to. To Raven's dismay, he picks another girl.
So, it's okay if I don't go to the convention with you?
Sure. Is it okay if I give you a ticket away?
As long as it puts a smile on my little horsey's face.
Hey, Phoebe. Got your ticket for you.
Phoebe. All the little horsey's over here and you had to pick her?
Now, in that moment, say had Raven moved too quickly, like right after Devon turned around, we would have missed the face, the small stomps on the ground so as to make her presence known, the waving of the hands to give off a "are you dumb" vibe, and the shaking of the head just to add a little sass. And if, say, she kept it going a bit longer, it would have been overkill. Or look at the scene from the episode where Raven and Corey have to go to the dentist.
Well, it usually helps if the patient can see someone else being examined.
Really?
Yeah, someone close to them.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Often a blood relative.
Do tell.
A sister.
I see.
Named Raven.
You lost me.
The rhythm for the scene was firmly in place as Raven and the doctor go back and forth. Then when she got to her final line, she was actually a little behind the flow. And that little pause was really important as it allowed for the information to be processed by not just Raven, but more importantly, the audience. We needed to fully and completely hear what was just said, because what was to come next was the punchline. It's easy to get trapped in a rhythm, so the tiniest divergence is noted, and if you want for people to laugh, they need to hear and understand the punchline. And if they're too busy stuck in a rhythm, they could miss it. But besides that point, and also looking at the timing of the punchline itself, and how she stresses certain syllables and doesn't finish others, simply showcases more of the personality of Raven, one that, among other things, knows, bows to, and is in tune with the ebb and flow of life and communication. Oftentimes, it can be said it's the little things that separate the good from the great. In Raven's case, her clear understanding and embodying of what it means to be a performer, someone who is fearless, committed, open, and uses everything that they have, in turn making it their own, is highlighted so tremendously throughout the series. And for Raven to be so young at the time is something that is noteworthy. Sure, you could say, well, I'd turn out the same way if I got to be around people like Cosby, Murphy, and Curry, but let's be honest here. You probably wouldn't, because in Raven's case, her light was already shining before she even got to consciously and or unconsciously study under them. And that is what got her ball rolling and got her big break. And of course, I would be remiss if I didn't mention the great ensemble cast that Raven had and her fellow co-stars, who were all just as talented, tenured, and were able to firmly meet Raven in the same comedic playing field. But there are some things that just can't be taught.
You got the right one, baby.
And the ones that can still don't necessarily guarantee success. It's about the person and what they choose to do with it that does. Raven went above and beyond. She was animated like no other, but by also recognizing and giving life to the smallest of details or the littlest of nuances that makes someone their own person, whilst also creating a connection or a sense of familiarity to anyone watching.
Yeah, I'm just a dancing fool!
That's not dancing fool.
Raven, without a doubt, has been able to cement herself as one of the comedy greats and a true legend in her own right.
Yep, that's me.